Hello and welcome to your astrological vibrations for Wednesday, December 12th, 2018 by Gaia Blooming. I am Mimi and our energy mantra for today is I allow time and space to nurture my light. And today we have Mercury shifting into Sagittarius. That shift will happen at 3:43 p.m. Pacific time, which means the first part of the day we have Mercury hanging out at that 29 degree mastery. Mastery of our power, mastery over our shadows and our light. And, you know, if you were a little bit cranky on Tuesday, you may feel a little bit cranky on Wednesday through this energy. Your first lesson, first message, lesson, is be very aware of any Scorpioing that may come up in and through you. I actually want to show you, like, today's day, like it really is divided in two, and it's so the cards, like the way I pulled them, I was like, oh my goodness. First part of the day, harmony reverse, hence intensity in reverse, and we have the nothingness, and that's like the shift, and we lead to source and this traveling, reaching for the light. The first part of the day with Mercury hanging out there, the stuff may still be coming to the surface. We still may be finding ourselves impatient, testy, scorpionic, lashing out. And we have to just be aware of that. It's the same as yesterday. Be aware of your light. Be aware of your personal responsibility. Be aware of tendency to blame anything. Be ready to step up, take your responsibility, and allow any time and space. If something is like pushing your buttons, the time and space to nurture your light in and through it, because in that case, you may respond in a way that's true to who you are rather than reacting from that other place. part of the connection that is happening during that day, though, which again will be benefited by time and space, is a very creative connection between the sun and the moon. The moon is in Aquarius, connecting to the sun in Sagittarius, creative, inspirational, bright, wide ideas can come through with this connection. It also is a connection that wants things to be like, okay, harmonious, like, hey, we may have different ideas, but we can still get along kind of feeling going on. Again, your impulse because of Mercury may be that lash, but if you take the time and space, you can probably get to the place like, oh, well, you have that idea and I have this idea and we can get along. So there's that. Then, like I said, Mercury shifting into Sagittarius, 3:43 p.m. Pacific time. With Mercury back in Sagittarius, it is once again about aiming our mind with the light, reaching for the light, thinking bigger. I love this traveling card because this really is like the epitome of so many things Sagittarius, whether it's traveling in a physical sense or traveling as in expanding your mind, expanding your mental horizons. Mercury in Sagittarius asks us to expand our mental horizons and keep reaching for the light in the next distant galaxy. Keep thinking bigger. There is something bigger to be grasped in and through this. We are still in Mercury's shadow period, so we're still getting some of those lessons. There may be some lessons around truths and beliefs that you've held on really tight to. Hold on loosely and just see what comes to you as you allow your fingers to peel off this thing. What is true cannot be disproven. So there's no need to cling to it, you know? The final thing I do want to mention, those are the only aspects for today. We do have the moon finishing up in Aquarius and will finish up early on Thursday morning. But before the moon finishes up, it's going to connect with Uranus. So that's happening at 2:20 a.m. Pacific time on Thursday morning. With the moon in Aquarius connecting to Uranus, sleep may be a little bit difficult. You may feel a little tired and wired, especially wired. When I can't sleep, I highly recommend meditation, tuning in, being restful just the same instead of freaking out over that I can't get sleep. I promise sleep rest is coming, especially after the moon shifts into Pisces. It might be like, oh yeah, okay, now I'm ready to sleep. But if you are getting that wired feeling, it's just a sign your nervous system needs you to help calm itself down. So, like I said, the first part of the day, we have this. We're not really necessarily moving at the speed of light towards the light. We're kind of moving away from it, but that's all the more reason to nurture the light, allow the time and space for the light. We've got harmony in reverse, but it just takes a little bit more consciousness to get into that harmonious state. Then we have the shift, the nothingness, and here we are, moving back towards the light, in our source, in our power. But you can work that all day long with the consciousness. So that is it for today. You can book a reading. I have started the 2019 Year Ahead readings. Ho 2019, it has lessons aplenty for us. You can book a holiday gift certificate for anybody that you would like. I have a printout that you can print out or email to anybody. And yeah, that's it for today. So you have the power. The better it gets, the better it gets. And there is enough love in the world for you. Namaste.